Hi guys, welcome to another video. Today we're going to talk about the denoiser of Octane. It's a very quick video, but we are going to clarify all the questions you have. So let's get started. So before we start using the denoiser, there are two things that you need to check out. The first thing is you have to go to the Octane forum and download the latest version of Blender Octane, especially the one that there are no bugs on the denoiser. Okay, so the one I'm using here is the 3.1.2 Blender, and the Octane version is the, let me check it out, is the 26.2. Okay, so this version I know that's working very well, and if you can, please download it. Okay, so this one is already the free tier. Okay, so you can download it for free. There is no problem at all. And also, the second thing that you need to check out is your driver, your NVIDIA driver. Okay, so mine was released on May 24, okay, the version is the 512.95. So it's important, guys, that you use the latest version of the NVIDIA driver. Okay, so this is very important. Otherwise, you won't be able, or you're going to have problems when you are rendering with denoiser. And if you don't want to have problems, issues on your denoiser, so please update everything and start over again, okay? So let's jump into the denoiser and see how it works. So there are two places that you need to go to start rendering with denoiser. The first one is the layer properties, and here on passes, you have to change the preview pass to the denoiser beauty. Okay, normally it comes with the combine, and you need to change it to the denoiser beauty. The second thing is you need to turn on denoiser on your camera. In this case, I'm overriding the Octane camera using this shortcut over here from Octane. So I'm overriding it, but you can always go to your camera and do the same thing because it's the same parameters. Okay, so here on the Octane camera, you need to turn on enable denoising. Okay, so I'm going to show you in the Octane camera, but as I just said, it's the same parameter, same thing. So here you have to enable denoiser. As I'm not using the parameters from Octane camera imager from here, and I'm using from here, doesn't matter if it's on or off. So Octane, you take the information from here. Normally, when you start using the denoiser from Octane, the default value is something like this. So basically what you need to do is go to the enable denoise and activate your render preview. Okay, so let's wait a little bit. And as you can see, nothing's happening, but it will happen soon. So let's wait a little bit more. I'm going to change the number of samples that I have, so I think it'll be easier. Let's change to 100 and render it again. So as you can see, nothing happened. I'm going to wait until the Octane reach the 100. Yeah, so now we have our denoiser applied to our preview render. But as you can see, it took 100 samples to apply the denoiser. And it happens because we have this denoiser all completion activated. So if I turn this off, actually it's going to apply the denoiser after 10 samples, and actually between 10 and 20 samples. Okay, so I'm going to increase this a little bit more to 100, to 500, something like that. And it will Actually, it will always depend on your NVIDIA graphic card, because if you have like a faster card, I noticed that it won't start after 10. It sometimes start after 50 or 100, depend on your graphic card. So let's check it out again. I'm going to turn off my render preview and I'm going to render again. So now we have 32, 64, 80, 100, and it's still, actually I didn't change the samples yet, it's the preview samples, so let's see again. 32, 64, 128. And as you can see, we still didn't get it because my graphic card is very fast actually. And it's taking a little longer for Octane to identify these numbers. So if I change it to 1, for example, you're going to see that it's going to be very fast. So let's take a look. So now we have 8 samples and yeah, it's done. Okay, so if you change it to 1 and 1, it's going to apply the denoiser immediately. So let's try another number. Let's try 5 and 10. And now probably it's going to apply it. 128. Yeah, now it's applied. So depending on your graphic card, this number will be more realistic or less realistic. It's going to depend on your graphic card, okay? Again, if you turn the denoiser completion, it's going to complete, actually it's going to wait until Octane reaches these 500 samples to apply it on the preview render, okay? So let's see again, let's see with 500. So you're going to see that it's going, Octane is going to wait until it reaches the 500 samples. So 100, 200, 300. And finally 500, and then we have the denoiser applied. Here we have the blend parameter where you can control how much noise, or in this case how much denoise, you want on your scene. Okay, so 0 means that the denoiser is applied in the entire image. And if you increase it to 1, it means no denoising. So you're going to have all the samples, all the noise that's still missing to clean it up. Okay, so let's see 0.5, so a little bit less noise, and 0.3. So normally I use around like 0.2, 0.3. Sometimes depending on the image I have. Okay, so probably I would increase a little bit more the samples to have a better result. And yeah, that's it. So that's it, guys. Hope you have enjoyed it, and let me know if you have any questions. But again, don't forget to update your Blender Octane and also the NVIDIA drivers. That's very, very important. Otherwise, you're going to see that you're going to have a lot of bugs. Okay, thank you and see you in the next video.